apologize real briefly. I do know it's late, so back in the studios, we're going to talk about the Earl Thomas situation. He's not coming into training camp or practice OTAs with the Seattle Seahawks. That's cool. The guy wants the money. Do we have money to burn? That's the thing. Do we have enough money to burn? We got Zach Martin situation. We got to pay that up. We got other situations out there too as well that we don't want to fall ourselves into the mind of just going out trying to craft our team together with a, I guess, quote unquote, high commodity. Now, granted, he did say that he would like to play for the Dallas Cowboys. That's a plus, you know. But would he take a hometown discount? That's the thing with Earl Thomas. We know for sure. Deion Sanders said he would like to see him with the number 29. I think the Michael Irvins of the world and everybody else, even with me, saying that with Chris Richard, we know that what he can bring to the table. We understand that. Shout out to Steven Adams. Shout out to Xavier. Hey, Steven Adams, man. First one in the mix too as well. Let me just put y'all name out here, man. Let's get this thing going, man. Shout out to y'all, man. Put the text box up so that people can see, you know, what's going on when I'm doing the shout outs and stuff like that. But this is the thing, guys. This is the thing. We have to figure out a way that we can craft this team to be even better than we were last year. And my thing is, it all falls on the aspect of where this defense lies. We understand what the offense is going to do. Everybody already counted Dak Prescott out, which is cool. But I'm not counting number 21 out. And we know who number 21 is. He's going to be the guy that's going to elevate everybody. But what we have to do as a team is get this defense together. This defense, although it's ranked 8th overall, although we pretty much had a very decent defense, top 10 if one can argue, but there are still reservations. There's still not a lot of turnovers. There still was times and plays where the opposition was saying, okay, if we want to run the ball, we can run it, you know. So those things speak volumes. Latham hurt already, and no one, not even out there to put hands on him, shaking my head. This is from, I guess, Jesse. That's how you say your name. And it's Latham Van Der Esch. Hey, my thing is with Latham Van Der Esch, I did tell everybody, hey, you guys know me. When we went and made that pick, I wasn't jumping out of the woodshed. You know, I wasn't jumping up for joy. My whole thing was, this guy's going to take time to develop. He come from the Mountain West. He come from Boise. Everybody know that Boise don't play like the Alabama. They don't play like the SECs of the world. I even had Boise State's apologists and Boise State fans and alum come out to me and say that, okay, Boise guys are pretty good. Look at Jay Ajayi, how you say his name. Look at what your guy DeMarcus Lawrence did. Look at Orlando Scandrick. Look at some other cats from Boise, man, Kellen Moores of the worlds. And I said, okay, Boise State, the best thing since sliced bread. My thing is with Boise State players, like the LV, it's still soon, so we can't call him out. We can't say that he's a trash of a pick at this point, because we have all of the faith and hope and good understanding that he's 6'4", 257 pounds. And we trying to say to ourselves, this guy's going to be the next best thing since sliced bread. So I'm going to speak positive. You know, we got to speak positive on this aspect of it. And hopefully he can just get his legs together and he'll be out there come week one. Let's go, Law. What's up, Joe Daddy? What's going on with you, man? Yeah, let's go, man. Shout out to y'all, man. Hey, California was good for me, man. It was good for me to get time to relax. You know, I jumped on the phone, tried to shoot the video through the phone. For those true soldiers out there who still watch the video, even though it wasn't the highest quality like I like to put out there, but appreciate you guys. I try to spit my mind. You know, I try to put what I have out there in thoughts, and I try to put that out to everyone. Hey, Pardon, what's going on with you, man? Shout out to you too as well. Zeke for MVP is from Jay. Zeke is everything, man. You guys saw Ezekiel Elliott out there leading the pack, leading the troops. I mean, shout out to notification squad too as well. Those who get the notification buzzer, man, who plucked the bell that's at the bottom of this video. Shout out to you guys too as well. And the Patreon troops, man. Shout out to you guys too as well. I was down, baby. That's the colorway, the best way. Guys, follow the colorway, man. That's the best way. Do we have money to burn, man? You see, that's the topic of the day right now. Do we really have the money, the remunerations, the pockets, you know, of change to throw away? Because that's the main thing. We got to have that one good player that we can put out there. We got to, man. We got to. If we don't, then we'll still see the same thing happening over and over again, that we get so close that we just don't make it, you know. What else we got? How about them Cowboys weapon in? Yeah. How about them Cowboys? Oh man. Let's hear it, man. Joe, I just came from a flight, jumped in the shower, threw on some stuff, man. Put this thing out here. And the thing is, I just want to be able to talk to you guys of what I feel about the David Irvins, you know, him not being in full effect. The Earl Thomas, you know, he's not going into camp. He said he want to retire pretty much. He want to end his career with the Seattle Seahawks. But we seeing from our eyes a lot of tongue in cheek, because nobody go run down Jason Garrett and say, hey, come get me. And if it's that the problem of us not going to get him, then it's going to be an issue, you know. If he put the price tag in a reasonable situation. You guys know what I mean? Who else we have? Is it Lil XAN Jr.? Oh, what's up, man? You know, what's good? Camacho, Belly Irvin. Hey. I don't want to be able to say thank you for tuning in to the Law Nation Film Session as we take a deeper look at Belly Irvin. First and foremost, his belly is sticking out a mile and he don't have the stamina. I do not want to say that. I want Belly Irvin to lose that name and come out with another stance. I want him to come out there ready to be locked and loaded and get to the quarterback, because this is the year. This is the year DeMarcus Lawrence can be right. Belly Irvin can lose the belly and be right on the other end. And then we sprinkle in a taco charter and we see what Coney Ealy can do and the Doris Armstrong. This finesse package, everybody have to be healthy in order for this finesse package to work. You see, I'm getting kicked in now. I'm getting ready now. You guys getting me amped up now. So if this can be the season that we go out there and grab a Earl Thomas, squeeze him in on this roster immediately. Xavier Woods' play is going to be better. Jeff Heath's play is going to be better. And whoever the undrafted free agent that we picked up, those players are going to be better, because now you have a seasoned vet who understands the philosophy of what Chris Richard wants. Now, this is the caveat here. I do know that everybody's saying that, okay, Law, what about our young guys? Why are you sleeping on our young guys? Give them chances and times to grow. You can be that guy to sit back and say, okay, I'm going to give everything for these young guys to grow, and we're going to go through this growing pain. Because when you playing this secondary deep safety and you missing the tackle, you missing your assignment, that's touchdown. The secondary, the deep safety, speaks volumes on how you can control the atmosphere as it relates to the seasoned quarterbacks that you play, especially this year. I do not want to see somebody taking the top off the defense and the safety climb down too far into the pocket or climb down too far in the box, and then all of a sudden we have a touchdown. We don't want to see that. I want my safety to have the wherewithal to understand whatever nuances, the new wrinkle that we throw out here. Because let's be honest, we have a different philosophy with this offense. It may take 2 to 3 weeks before this offense can start gelling. Come week one, we need our defense to be solid. Every game is important, especially coming out of the NFC East. All these teams pretty much is like the SEC of the NFL. The NFC have more Super Bowls than any other division in the NFL. Think about that. And they play each other hard. They don't like one another. It's always been grittish. It's always been grimish with these teams. It's always been a gut check with one of these teams. So we need to come out guns a-blazing. We need to win every game that we step foot in. And we have to do that with just taking over this year. Because we know that we had a suspect year last year. And we had, it was one person. And I don't like the argument saying that it was Dez's fault. I don't like the argument saying it was Dak Prescott's fault. I don't like the argument saying that it's the coaching fault. And I don't like the argument saying that it's the wide receivers collectively in the offensive line. Everybody across the entire board didn't play up to par. We can only look at probably our secondary, maybe. But even in certain games, they wouldn't just like lights out, you know. So what we need to do this year, coming out of the gates, everybody must be beating on the same page. Everybody must be singing from the same, old folks, you say everybody must be singing from the same hymnal, you know what I mean? So the Callaway, the best way, say 11-5. I can feel with that. I can rock with that. I can roll with that. The Hawk Rage Cowboy, what's up, man? I can tell the Eagles never won a Super Bowl before. They think it's automatic now. Hawk rage, Hawk smashing on the Eagles, man. That's what I'm talking about, man. Hey, we eating a lot of crow as Cowboys Nation, Cowboys fans, Cowboys Elite out here. Hey, somebody need to maybe make their YouTube name Cowboys Elite. I like that name. But we all know that the Eagles are on their high horses. Rightfully so, they won a Super Bowl. Can you imagine how we would feel if we won a Super Bowl? But it took them over 50 years, so let's just give them a shout out. Let them do their thing. But it is what it is. Shout out to Pam. Hey, 11-5, I can roll with that, but I'm leaning more towards 12-4, believe it or not. Joshua Whitlock. Oh, speaking of Whitlock, Jason Whitlock and Terrell Owens getting into like a beef battle, man, over Twitter, their Twitter fingers and all that stuff. And Jason Whitlock, I don't know if you guys watch, I think it's First Take or Undisputed or something, whatever, FS1 or something like that. Jason Whitlock, he goes on national TV and said, well, T.O. is not only the team obliterator or the world's team and the world hated or the worst teammate ever, but now he's been selected to the Hall of Fame, and now he's the worst Hall of Fame teammate or team player ever. And you know that what Michael Irvin said about T.O. too as well, he kind of, you know, spoke the truth about the man. And T.O. comes back with a crazy tweet saying that, I'll be there if you lose 100 pounds and lay off the donuts, basically. And he said to Michael Irvin, oh, and I'll bring some donuts to you, Michael Irvin, the powder kind. I said, man, now you know Michael Irvin, he's cool, you know. Michael Irvin had a tendency to get under people's skin when you get all emotional. But they're going to have to run across one another. And somebody told T.O. that. And T.O. said, when I see him, we'll see what's going to happen. So if that's not fighting words, man, I don't know what that is, but I mean, come on, man. You don't want to be vilified through your whole entire life. But it is what it is, man, with T.O. But that's what I heard when I was on the plane, man. I was like, man, T.O. and Mike Irvin. But Mike Irvin, pretty much, so he got skins on the wall. You know, he got urns in the fire. He got hardware, as they say. So it's crazy, man. T.O. found his way to still be in the media, still being in the news. Hey, Pam said 88 all day. 88 will shine. Who's going to wear number 88? No one. They're going to put that number 88 in a glass box and just throw it away. I don't think we're not going to see another 88 in a Cowboys uniform as far as long as we don't see another 82. It's going to be one of those things. What it do, brother? Shreveport in the building right down the street, man. What up, Shreveport? What's going on with you? Yeah, don't forget to put down where you guys are from. I love to hear that, man. Next draft, Romello. They shouldn't go with the next draft. Monroe, Louisiana, what's up? They're the building. Shout out to you guys, man. That's wrong. T.O. could have lit up. Could get lit up by 88 on the site. You know, that's Justin Quarles. I mean, a man, I always say walk it. You know that song that came out, you know, a couple of weeks ago, walk it like you, walk it like I talk it, you know. I mean, you walk the walk, talk the talk, walk the walk, however they say, you know, Waco in the building, what's up? Where my Oak Cliff guys at, man? Shout out to Oak Cliff too as well. Hey, we gonna see how this thing gonna unfold and see what's gonna go on, man. Xavier, what's up, man? Walk it like I talk it. That's what I'm talking about, DJ. DJ got me right, man. Walk it like I talk it. That's what you gotta do, man. And hey, I mean, the thing is with me is that I like to make my actions speak louder than my words. You know, if I see something that I know that I can do it, you know, I try to make my actions speak louder than my words. Some people like to talk a good game and then they don't deliver. Some people like to say, even in the chat box, they like to come at me a little bit. Not you guys. You guys are 100. Y'all real deal, Holyfield. But some people, man, get all in the comments, get all in their feelings. They talk all this stuff. They type with their fingers. And I'm sitting here saying, man, where your video at? Where your video? Put that video on, man. Let's put things on wax, man. Yeah, we would. Next Level Cowboys can do it. Yeah. So this is the thing too as well. This is the thing that we really want to talk about with the Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott. How many touchdowns he's going to get this year? That's what I want to know. I want to know you guys' thoughts and opinion. Ended Nola in the house. What's going on, man? The Delta, Mississippi. Mondale, what's going on? Let me know what you guys think. Is it going to be a plus 12 touchdown type of year? Because when Emmett got plus 15 touchdowns, hey, we found ourselves in the playoffs. We found ourselves making a deep run, deep impacts. So 16, 12, 20, man, that's what I'm talking about. Rushing touchdown. No, we're going to be like, not just rushing. Remember earlier, at those who keep following the channel, I said our best slot receiver, believe it or not, is number 21. That's our best slot receiver. I mean, the guy can catch the ball out of the backfield, can get small, get skinny, and scoot up, and catch the edge, and he can take it to the house. 0-60 real quick. Now, you put that with the Tavon Austins of the world, and even if you go with it like a, let's say if you go with this setup right here, you got Tavon, well, of course you got Tavon Austin, who is interchangeable with the slot, but now you got Tavon Austin in the backfield who can line up in the slot, and then you can go with a setup, with a pro-style setup, whereas you can have Jamez Olawale in the backfield with Ezekiel back there, or you can be interchangeable with a Rod Smith, misdirectional plays. I mean, for one, this is what teams gonna end up doing. To count for the speed, they might take their linebacker out and put an extra DB. Now, when you put an extra DB out there, see, Ezekiel Elliott is not like a frail type of running back. He's a plower. And then he's finesse. So you put an extra DB out there immediately, you compromise your whole entire defense because you're getting lighter, you know. Then if you put an extra linebacker out there, it just gets too crazy and convoluted at that point because now your team is just too slow. So I'm really thinking that the way I think Scott Linehan, and I do know a lot of people don't like Scott Linehan, but I'm thinking that what he's going to do with the well-back situation is that you guys remember when he coached up Reggie Bush. I think that he had him for a few years, right? I think Reggie Bush had like over 1,000 yards receiving one year. Something like that. You guys find the quotes for you guys find the stats for me and post it down whenever you get a chance. But I'm thinking that they're going to utilize Tavon Austin as an interchangeable wide receiver / Reggie Bush type of style of runner guy. You know, it's going to be something real nice out there if you can have a healthy Ezekiel Elliott and this whole package with this offense. It's going to be nice, man. I'm not just trying to just put everything into sugar and spice for you guys, but it's going to be nice. And for those who just think that, hey, you got to have a quarterback to launch that thing, No, this running back situation is going to open up everything. It's going to open up everything. What is it? Malik White, what's up, man? He said, what it do, Law, from ATL Live, man. Hey, man, it's 12:32, man. You rolling with the brother today, man. What's going on? What's cracking, big dog? What's going on, young? What's going on? Hawk Rage, man. Zeke will feast on the East. Yeah, you're going to bust it wide open, man. It's gonna bust this thing wide open, man. Law, what's going on with this young Wilson? He said, Law, B-O-B, young. You know what I'm talking about? Aloha, you know. Alita La Raza, mucho elegante. That's me, you know, all day, you know. Dan Bailey, anyone? Xavier. I think that he should be healthier now. I think that Dan Bailey is going to be a guy that is going to get his mind together as far as kicking. I think that he should step it up, though. He missed some few crucial quick kicks last year. I think he cost us at least probably one game. And I think that he will be best this year. He will be back to his best self. 27 touchdowns this year. Oh, my God, man. That would be nice. That would be nice, collective touchdowns, rushing and passing. This, we talking about Ezekiel Elliott. Going back to Ezekiel Elliott, that would be nice. All day, baby, rocking and rolling. Yeah. Just for that, man, let me wake y'all up just a little bit. Let me wake y'all up. All right, so what we got? Oh, we got to talk about Jawar. Jahad Ward, I meant to say. This is from Young Wilson. I haven't really dove into what DallasCowboys.com was really saying about him. I have yet to read any articles on Jahad Ward. The only thing that I can see from what I saw from his like tape that I did, a quick snippet of what he can do out there, I think Jahad Ward is a bigger, stronger, less flexible, less mobile Belly Irving. So the thing is with this, now he don't have like a multiple moves within his tool belt. He got this one bull rush move and he's slow off his get off. So I'm really gonna have to see what Rob Marinelli is gonna craft and mold and shift him and make him to become. It's just like, I put a big placeholder on Jahad Ward. I'm not really high on him at this point. He's gonna have to really show me some improvement through training camp and through these many preseason games that we have. I hope that he have the stamina to play at least, as far as snap wise. He's gonna have to get north of 30 snaps this year. Hopefully he can get that. I really wanna see what Jahad Ward. Guys who don't understand who Jahad Ward is, go look, just type in under the search engine, type in Jahad Ward. You'll see a few snippets out there. He don't have a lot of snaps and he don't have a lot of tape. But from what I can see, from what I pulled together from the NFL Network and the NFL Game Pass, those were the things that came out to me. Slow get off, strong strength. He got powerful hands, do one bull rush, but that's all he have. That's on Jahad Ward. C-Money, what's up, C-Money in the mix? What's going on, man? OJ in the building. Solomon, what's up, Law? Keep killing them with the knowledge, my man. Hey, I try so hard. Let's go with Alan Hearns. Yeah, I love this. I love when you guys throw me a player y'all want me to talk about. My thing is with Alan Hearns is the fact that this is going to be his first year that we pointing to him. Now, he's not anointed to the position yet. But he got to go out and earn it because Michael Gallup, don't sleep on him. Not saying that a rookie is just going to cement a 5-year or 6-year player. But what's going on with this is that, to me, not to anybody else out there, not to the other scouts, not to Pro Football Focus, not to... As Brian Broaddus would say, Joe and Flyermount, this is to me. I think that you can utilize Alan Hearns a whole lot better within the slot. line it up at the Y and Z, line them inside, maybe motion them out to the outer edges of a play. I think that he creates the ultimate mismatch because he have quick, short area quickness. He had the height, the range, and the subtle burst off his stance. And you guys gonna see when he gets off his release, he explode off his release. There's no hesitation. The guy runs routes and he can catch the short tightness of the ball. He's a good, I'm talking about a good guy that can track the ball within the air and the tight windows passes. He will catch those things. Now, this is the caveat here. This is the thing that I have to say with Allen Hurns. The stage will be big. Playing in the Dallas Cowboys game is you will have the Monday night games, you will have the primetime slots, you're gonna have all the national media focusing on you. That is the one conundrum that we really don't bring up when you're talking about Dallas Cowboys players, you know. And rightfully so, we the America's team, but in on the flip side, you have to be ready. And reason why, if you guys go back and watch this tape that I cut up of his breakdown, shout out to those who watched those clips. It was against the Patriots. And the problem is with that whole entire tape was the fact that they lost. They could have won that game. They was up 20-7 at one point. And it was a big primetime game because it was the AFC Championship. And the thing that I saw with Allen, I was looking to see, will he be able to step it up in big time games? And he stepped it up. But what I want to see now is, can he stay healthy? And can he show me that consistency come Sunday to Sunday when you're talking about playing for the Dallas Cowboys? Because we all know that this fan base, we would turn on you quick. And all it takes is for him to drop one crucial pass, and we're just gonna automatically say that the guy can't play. So that's what I really want to see. Can this guy step it up, and can he perform on the biggest, and I'm talking about the brightest stage, and have the critics all at your throats? Because think about this: if you guys turn on, I can guarantee you, this week alone, that when you turn on the First Take, Undisputed, Fox, Tupac and Biggie show, you're gonna see the Cowboys topic this week. It's just given. It's just gonna be a Cowboys topic. You're not gonna see no Browns topics. You're not gonna see no New England Patriots topics. Or Jaguars topic. You're gonna see a Dallas Cowboys topic. All right, so who else are we gonna talk about? We're gonna talk about I seen somebody put in here. What we got? I saw somebody, Patriots versus Cowboys. That's cool. Arlington, shout out to Arlington Man in the mix. Arlington is real nice, man. Guys, it's real nice. Hey, the Arlington Walmart. If you ever want Cowboys apparel, go to the Arlington Walmart. It got everything you can imagine. It got everything you can think of. Keychains, watches. Hell, they got everything, man. It's the Arlington Walmart. Mike White, Connor Gallup, all showing promise so far. Yeah, Mike White, I'm telling you, guy can throw the ball through a keyhole. He's poised. He had the size, the measurables. I just really want to see him live too as well. I'm not putting a placeholder on him like I did Jahad Ward, but I'm really just really want to see him, what he's going to look like against, you know, NFL quality players that's out there on the field. Now, as far as Connor Williams, he's solid. I have nothing to say about Connor Williams. He's solid. Gallup, I have the same thing that I have on Allen Hurns, I have on Gallup. I really want to see, because Gallup is my pet cat, and I'm not going to tell you guys who I really want to compare him to. I'm going to do it like week three. I'm going to go to Shady Ray. I'm not going to just go out there and say, this guy would remind me of. So I'm going to go to week three, and I'm going to say, hey, I told you guys, this is who he remind me of, you know. But the guy, from what I can see on tape and what I can see out there on the quick snippets that people put out there who got access to the training camp and don't want to really share it to nobody, it's all cool. But who got access, I'm not going to say their name. But people who have access to those clips out there, the guy looks like very promising. And it's not a cause to pause for our DBs, but it's one of those things where I'm sitting like, man, that ball that he caught was really uncatchable, but he just retched around and caught it with his hand, brought the ball to his body. I'm talking about the guy's beasting. Rico is beast. I'm going to wait for Rico. I'm going to wait on Rico. I don't care what he do. None of this thing during preseason. I'm waiting on Rico to show up week one against the Carolina Panthers. That's what I really want to do. As a matter of fact, if Rico play week one against the Carolina Panthers and he goes like just ball out that game, I will then anoint him off of one game. That's how much faith I have in him. But until I see that one game of him playing in the National Football League against a real game, a regular season game, if he shows up that one game, I'm going to really put him on the map. He's already going to be on the map, but I'm really just going to put all of my thoughts, my soul into him on his gameplay. But I just want to see one good game. Because scouts always say if you can see it once, you can know you can see it again. And I just want to see him play that one good game. Isaac Bruce is from Mafia, man. Yeah, Isaac Bruce is a man. Whoever you guys are talking about are going to refer that to. Irvin might beat up T.O. Oh, man, I think that this is from Justin. If I was Irvin, I'll take the high road. It's not trying to just be soft or anything. But at this point, Michael Irvin got more to lose than Terrell Owens. Michael Irvin already been a three-time championship winner, and he also been a national championship winner in college. He got guaranteed checks coming in from NFL Network. He's been on the radio. And then he doesn't need the validation. I always tell people this right here. Validation is only good for parking. I don't think that T.O. should just even try to approach Michael Irvin on that aspect of whatever Michael Irvin said about T.O. T.O. should have been like, okay, that's a legend talking to me. I need to sit down and listen. But at the point, he just flip it over, and Michael Irvin on the opposite side, Michael Irvin, all he need to do is just say this. Okay, young buck, he's smelling himself. I'm gonna let him ride. I'm gonna remember that. That's cool. That's how I play it, you know. Okay, that's cool. There's pockets, there's places that I can go that this young man would never know. That's Michael Irvin, you know what I'm saying? So that is what Michael Irvin should do. Who's this? Roberts, what's up? Listening to Law Nation while on my way home from Austin, man. Shout out to you, man. I appreciate it, man. Hey, I'm glad I can deliver to you, man, as far as my information, my thoughts. Why we keep Randy Gregory around? What do you think? Why we keep Randy Gregory around, you think? You know, this is from White, my guy. I love you guys putting you guys' insight. This is why we should always understand. I touched on this before with Randy Gregory. The guy really showed some promise against the Giants game, and then we had the high ankle sprain. I immediately said he's finna smoke a blunt, and I understand. You know, some people, you know, medicate themselves with Tylenol, aspirins, with opiates, whatever, you know. Some people medicate themselves different ways, but when you're talking about depression and in pain, not trying to create a window of like built-in excuse, I see a lot of promise with Randy Gregory. And I think I see some growth with Randy Gregory now. He can understand that he's missing out on money. You have a daughter now, and he's not getting those big checks that he's supposed to be getting at this point. His contract is not guaranteed at this point because he's been suspended for PED or whatever, substance abuse, what have you. So all that is just thrown out the window. But the thing is, what I want to see with Randy Gregory is for him to stay focused, stay off the weed, at least adhere to NFL rules and policies. And although the NFL said he had pretty much passed his pretty much his last five or six drug tests or what have you. So what we need to have, and I don't know if you guys fill me in because I haven't heard any other news on this. If Roger Goodell adhered to, you know, I guess Randy Gregory plea, you get Randy Gregory out there, then you immediately have a better band rush or somebody come out the edge. Pretty much, I can say this, and this is just coming off of college tape and a few clips that I saw when he played against the pros. Randy Gregory got the best band on this team. I'm talking about if you can just look at the way he can come off that edge and his shoulder can get so low. I'm talking about his shoulder. It feels like a lawnmower blade. It will cut the grass. How he's coming off the edge and he can meet the quarterback within the pocket. You know, meet the quarterback at the edge. So if you get a focused Randy Gregory, and you have the defensive front that we have now, although it's finessed as hell, we don't have a big guy that can just collapse the pocket and demand a double team. I really think that if you can get these teams one-dimensional, because it could be like one of those things where it's we run, and we score when we get to the money zone, red zone, green zone, and then we can have the other team, the opposition, pressing to score, so they get out of their run and they can start passing. And now that you have a Randy Gregory, then you rotate a Dorrance Armstrong, who's 6'4", too, as well, and then you have a Taco, who's 6'7", and then you have length. You have all this length out here, Belly Irvin. You have length out there. You got the Kung Fu Warrior D-Law. The guy got quick, nasty hands. Shout out to Bosch Lombardi. Go check out his D-Law hand film session, the film breakdown. That guy was amazing breaking down his hand techniques, find out his hand placement. That is who D-Law is. You couple that with all what we have with, and then you throw in Malik. And then whatever Crawford can give you, you know, and whatever a Price and an Asher or whatever those bigger guys can do for you, you know. It's just all jelly on top of the biscuit. All right, so what we have, how in the hell you get caught up with dirty on one of your tests? This is crazy. This is from David. I don't know, you know, I haven't caught up with the news. Y'all fill me in with the David Irvin news. Hope David Irvin gets his stuff together. This is from Trey Craig, man. Yeah, I see you, fam. Shout out to you, man. Law. Why are you up, fam? I'm trying to get readjusted. I'm coming in from San Diego time. It's like 10 o'clock where they at. I just flew in, made it into back to Dallas, and I'm off tomorrow, you know. So that's why I'm still up. I got all this energy. I can be asleep right now. Try to go to sleep, but I'm just going to be thinking about the Cowboys, thinking about the team that I don't just like, I love. I'm just going to be doing that. Why not get my fix talking to you guys about the Dallas Cowboys? Oh, man. You guys know I should be really looking at some film, though, to be honest to you. Let me see who we're looking at. I looked at Connor Williams film. I looked at LV film. I just didn't put those film sessions out yet. Who else? Mike White. I was supposed to be doing Mike White film. Who else I didn't do, though? Who else I really did? Cedric Wilson. Oh, I know who I can do. Because I like to do film sessions on NFL players with the NFL All 22. It's so hard to find these college films. And the college film is fickle, you know, because sometimes when you do college film, it can get very convoluted, man, with a whole bunch of other stuff. But NFL film, for me, is just fair game. I can do Tavon Austin film session. I don't think I did a Tavon Austin. What he brings to the team, how we can utilize him in the field, in the backfield, how he can line up, he can flex around on that line too as well. I saw Tavon Austin actually line up to the outside, so if you can squeeze him and you can put Cole Beasley into the mix. And I think that they might just do a reverse sweep and give Cole Beasley the ball. That's gonna fake out everyone, you know, because everybody gonna say, okay, they're gonna give it to Tavon, you know. So I might do that, you know. I ain't complaining, Law. What's Chris Torres? What's up, man? Talk to me, man. What you not complaining about? Talk to me. Let me see. Is this something that you were talking about earlier? I don't know, man. Talk to me, man. You said I ain't complaining, Law. What you talking about? Talk to me. Tell me what's on your mind before I roll up out of here, man. Before I roll up out of here, man, tell me what's on your mind. Vander Ashfield. This is from Money Making Mall. What's up? So you want to do Vander Ash? You want me to do a Vander Ash? Bo, I did Bo already. Anchorage, Alaska, man. What's up? We in the building, man. I hope your heater working, boy. I can't deal with that cold, boy. Oh, man, we got people from Alaska in the house. Ready for the season to start. This is from Todd Jeff. Man, I got you guys up late at night. Film showing what Earl Thomas bring to the team. This is from Chris Torres. The thing is with Earl, man, I want him so bad on this team. I know what he would do for this team. I do know a lot of people talk about his age factor. But if you bring Earl on this team immediately, you're top five. You move up three slots on this defense. And then on top of that, even before he leave, you're going to have Earl-isms or Thomas-isms of his philosophy, of the way he was able to play for these amount of years, the way he was able to take angles and track the ball in space. Out watching a documentary on Emmitt Smith when he played for the Arizona Cardinals. He passed on some information to Anquan Boldin and Larry Fitzgerald and some of those guys that was on their team, and they said it stuck with them. And they said the reason being was, and I didn't know, I said, dang, Larry Fitzgerald was on the team when he was playing. And it was true. So all this stuff stuck with them, and they utilized the way Emmitt Smith was able to craft himself together. So that's what I'm saying, that's why I really like to have at least one veteran. Don't go out there and get five or six veterans that are old longer than two veterans out there on your team. I like the idea and the notion that we saw such a young team, but we still need to have somebody who's been there before, who pretty much had playoff experience, can tell you and say, hey, dog, you know what I mean? Hey, bruh, you might want to get that sleep tonight. Hey, bruh, this guy have a tendency to cut off on his route. You might want to jump him on his route. Or you might want to jam him. You might want to start trash talking him in the second quarter versus the first quarter. Those things, you know, the small stuff, the intangibles that we just don't see. The coach out there on the field, somebody who can just say, hey, although coach is calling this play, but let me tell you what I know for sure that's going to work. We just going to roll with it. Give the coach his power. Give the coach his props. But I'm going to call this ZX Niner play. You know, I'm going to mix this thing up. And that's what I like with veteran players. And y'all know that Tony Romo was doing that when he was the quarterback. You know, he mix it up and coach call it, hey, you know, Spider Yankee Niner. Four, hut, you know. And Tony Romo said, hey, no, we're going to scrap that. We're going to throw this fade over the days, you know, because the last matchup they gave us, it looked like this, and this is what we can get away with. That's veteran talking to you, you know. So that's why I love veteranship. Robert Armstrong, he's saying 13-3. That would be nice, but I'm ready for us to get that chip, man, somehow, some way. But 13-3 will be nice, plus the chip. That will be nice. 11-5 Super Bowl, yes, that will be nice. Law, who's your sleeper player this year? And who your surprise? Who will surprise us? You know, my pet cat is Michael Gallup. My sleeper would be, if you're talking about drafting, I don't have really a person that you just, this is going to come out of the woodshed. But my thing is, I really think that Randy Gregory, if he can get his mind together and stay off the weed, and that Roger Goodell can stay out of his mess too as well, I think that Randy Gregory can really surprise us all. Number one is from the Doppler boy is in the building. You know, he said Randy Moss number one, Terrell Owens number two, Calvin, he didn't have the heart to continue to play football, Johnson is number three. Okay, I can go with that. C Money number one is Nick Foles. I don't know the category you're talking about, you know, the luckiest guy of all time. Oh man, the last TD drive by Romo to Philly was beautiful. Beautiful. Was that the last touchdown that T-Wheel caught? let me know. X Woods, this is from 901 Cowboys Mafia. Shout out to you, man. X Woods could learn the trade. He could learn a lot of things from Earl the Pearl Thomas. Earl the Thomas. This is only one Earl the Pearl. You guys know what I'm talking about. You the man, Law Steven Rodriguez, man. What's up, man? Nah, you guys the man. I work for you guys. And like I said, it's always best to be seen and not viewed. And hey, if you guys want to continue to help support the channel, this is just my closing remarks on a lot of things. Don't forget, there's a link down in the description box called Patreon. That's where all the NFL games going to be at this year. That's where all of the hidden documentaries that you guys love to watch, like the All for Nothing or All or Nothing, I meant to say. Pretty much was nothing all last year. But it gives you insights of what the coaching philosophy is. And I know a bunch of you guys have already saw most of it. It gives you the insight of what Jason Garrett does, Jerry Jones, how he operates his business, and how Roger Goodell had his thumb all up, you know what, all last year. You know, that's where you guys can watch those clips at too as well. I had to take them down from YouTube because you know the policies and stuff like that. Hey, I try to keep it real, man. You know, I try to keep it real. This is a live show. So you guys know that I don't try to do all that editing, and if I mess up, sue me. And you guys know, I try to give you guys the real flow, the realness of me. And I do know that some people that watch it like the next 3 or 4 days from now, they say, hey, man, what the hell are you talking about, man? You're talking all slurry, you're talking all this. But hey, man, it's going on 1 o'clock at night, man. Give a brother a break, right? But it's live, so you guys don't hear no cut-ups and stuff like this. And then on top of that, it's straight talk. There's no, hey, I'm going to a commercial break, we'll be back in 5 minutes and stuff like that. So it's just me talking for an hour straight. So pretty much with that being said, I'm gonna give a few shout outs to you guys. Don't forget to put where you're from, how long you've been following the channel. If you like me, give me a thumbs up on the deal. If it's going on Facebook, don't forget to like this page, comment, and share. That helps me out more than you guys know. So don't forget to like, share, put it on Twitter somewhere, put it to your Instagram, however you share it. And it's just how it is. Richmond, VA in the house, man. 11 in Cali. California got some weird weather, man. It's cold. It's just cold at night, cold in the morning, and it gets warm in the evening. It was like one of those things where you don't know whether or not you're wearing a jacket in the morning, you know, or you're wearing some Gap shorts. It was just crazy. But the beach, the weather is still nice. It's 74, 75 degrees all year. But you got to be careful when you're walking around Cali, and that's Southern California. Earth, what's up, man? This is Camacho. He's put Earth in there. That's where he's from. That's what I like to hear, man. I'm from Earth, too. Peace, Law. See you next time. Hey, man, guys. I see you guys, too, as well. That's been my time. Hold on. Before I say, we got Vegas in the house, Frisco, Texas, right down the street. Listen from San Antonio. Hey, man, if you guys driving, I hope you get home safe. And, hey, this week, we're going to have a nice, wonderful week. Good, nothing but positive news. We're going to get this thing going one way or another. And Baltimore, we love you too as well. Baltimore in the house too as well. Hey, that's been my time. I really thank you guys for yours. And remember, you're listening to Nothing But the Best. Now let's jam out. Salute. Peace. Let's jam it on out, guys. I hope you guys have a good night. What's up?